Hey, what's up? It's Jared with State of Tech, and earlier today I put out a video with some actual gameplay of Fortnite on Android. Of course, that was announced today. The CEO of Epic Games made that announcement at the Unpacked 2018 event for the Galaxy Note 9, and I've been getting a lot of questions because I got that video up super fast. There are a lot of different Galaxy devices out there, and so people wanted to know what actually the requirements are. Like, a lot of people aren't seeing Fortnite in the Galaxy App Store, and so I just want to kind of go through what you have to have in order to play Fortnite on Android now, and then what to expect in the near future. So, like I said in the earlier video, they're calling it Fortnite Beta for Android, or Android Beta, and they're not necessarily saying it's an exclusive thing for Samsung, but there's no availability anywhere else unless you have a Samsung. So, Samsung users got that beta early. And so I wanted to let you know a little bit about what those minimum requirements are. So right now you're gonna have to have a Samsung device that is either a Galaxy S7 or S7 Edge or newer. So that also includes the S8, the S8 Plus, the S9, and the S9 Plus, which is what the gameplay was that I showed you in the other video. If you didn't see that video yet, make sure to check out the link in the description, or I'll put the card up there for you to click on as well. Alternatively, of course, if you have a Note 8 from last year, that's going to work. If you have a Tab S3 or the new Tab S4, that's going to work as well. Beyond that, if you have any other device, it's not going to work. I know there are a lot of other Samsung phones. Some of the phones are a little bit underpowered, I believe, for that. And so there's definitely a lot of system requirements that are going to need to be present. Now, people are reporting not seeing it on S7 devices that are running Android version 7.0 right now. The current version of Android is 8.0. And so if you don't have an Android device, I believe, that is running at least 8.0, you may not see it. And I'm not 100% sure what version 7 of the S7 or S7 Edge actually runs on. A lot of people, I think, because Samsung phones typically don't get a whole lot of future upgrades, they don't even really know what version of software their phone has, because they're not on a phone like, you know, a Pixel or something like that, a Google branded phone, where the big milestone upgrades in software year over year are more noticeable. So they don't have any information on their website saying that you need to have Android 8.0 in order for it to work, but I've yet to find anybody that says otherwise. On their website, according to the specs, as long as you have Android version 5.0 or newer, it should work. And so that should be fine. But if you're not seeing it yet, you want to make sure that all of your system software on your phone is up to date. Go into that settings screen down at the bottom. Make sure the software updates are done. Make sure you go into the Galaxy App Store and make sure that all of your updates are ran there. You want to make sure that everything is up to date, because you are going to need the latest version of everything that your phone has to offer. And that's going to be different if you're on the S7 versus the S8 versus the S9, or even some of the other Galaxy devices that are out there. So I've got some links down in the description below. I'm sure Epic Games and Fortnite, they will add some additional information there as soon as they can. Right now, the information is kind of scarce. There is a sign up if you don't have one of these devices and you want maybe one of these other devices to be supported. There is beta sign up, and so you do need to actually go to their website and sign up for their email invite. And you could go ahead and do that right from their website, and you'll be notified. There's a good list of phones that are supported or are gonna come with support when beta is extended out beyond the Samsung users. So you'll wanna make sure to sign up so you can get notified. You also wanna look at that list to make sure that you have a device that is gonna work. So for example, Google, all of their Pixel phones from Pixel first version, second version, and of course, third version when that comes out will probably be supported. The Asus, the newer Asus ROG phone, the Republic of Gamers phone, the Zenfone 4, the 5Z and the V, the Essential phone, the PH1, the newer Huawei phones, the newer LG phones from the G5 on, including the ThinQ and the V20, V30, and V30 Plus, the Nokia 8, the OnePlus 5, 5T, and 6, the Razer phone, which might be a great one to play Fortnite on when it comes available. And the Xiaomi has a variety of phones from the Mi 5 or the Mi 5 all the way to the Mi Note 2. ZTE has some. There's phones that are currently unsupported, like some HTC, Lenovo, and Sony phones that they're working on in the near term. And then, of course, they say if your phone's not on this list, it might still work, assuming that you have the following specs: a minimum of 3 gigs of RAM, which is going to knock out a lot of phones right there. A lot of phones only have more than 3 gigs of RAM up to a couple of years ago, and so that may knock you out. And if you saw the gameplay that I had in that other video, you're going to know that you're going to need probably more than that, because I know that my S9 Plus has way more than 3 gigs of RAM. It also has way higher of a processor support than what's listed here. And it was running Android OS version 8.0 or whatever the current version is on that device. So yeah, I highly recommend at least signing up for the beta invite here, because from what they are saying, it is a rolling, they're rolling out invites to people. So the sooner you get on that list, the faster you're going to get access. Just make sure that you have one of those devices or your gameplay is gonna vary. And it can be very easy to get frustrated about this, because iPhone has extremely smooth gameplay. It's 30 frames per second, but it's really smooth gameplay on most of the newer iPhones and newer iPads. But you have to take into consideration, Epic Games had to build Fortnite for an iPhone and for an iPad, whereas this Android version has to cover so many different possibilities, and supporting all those devices and making sure your gameplay is smooth is a challenge. So with that said, I just wanted to share all of that information with you, because people are asking those questions. I'm responding to the comments as quickly as I can, but I wanted to put the information out there because I know most of you are really excited to play Fortnite on Android, and so hopefully this video helped you out. If it did, give it a thumbs up. If you didn't watch my actual gameplay video yet, make sure to go and do that, because you'll see kind of the performance that I was able to get out of the most recent current Android device, most powerful Android device that there is right now. Of course, the Note 9 will be more powerful, but that's not shipping yet. So let me know what you think down in the comment section. List your device that you were able to get it to work on. I would love to see people sharing, like, I got it to work on this device, or it worked on this, but it was really slow and it was like impossible to play. Let us know, because there are so many people out there wanting to play Fortnite on their Android devices and needing to know what they can expect. So share that down in the comment section below. Give us a thumbs up and subscribe to us here on State of Tech to get notified when we put out new videos. As we get some updates, we'll start to put some stuff out too and share that with all of you. If not on our YouTube channel here, either on our Instagram account or Twitter. So make sure to follow us there. Links are down in the description. Thanks again. Hope to see you back here soon on State of Tech.